Alright, we're with Jake Thomson here, TNT International. You made your debut for the senior team, but I think your most memorable experience must be playing at the Under 20 World Cup in Egypt. How did your career, what was it turning your career after that? How did things go?
It was strange because when I first got the opportunity, I was delighted and I was excited. So I left Southampton obviously to come away, and during that time I was playing, and the manager was a bit disappointed to see me go, but obviously it was a World Cup and he understood and I kind of had to go. And then when I come back, the team was winning and like I couldn't force my way in. So he said, like, do you want to take yourself out on loan? So I went out on loan and managed to play a lot more football. So it was a positive and somewhat a bit of a negative as well, because I kind of lost grounds with my own team but made like international strides. So if you was to say I'd have the opportunity to do the same, like to do it again a couple of years ago, then I'd make the exact same decision.
But it must have a mental effect on you. Tell the people, you know, what you would have had to go through, because, you know, when you leave the national team and you go back to your club, you more or less you fend for yourself. The TTFF or your national team coach is not there to protect you or push you, and you end up in a situation where your back's against the wall. What was that like for you?
I mean, it was really difficult. It was tough for me because I hadn't gone through it before, and I mean I was on a massive high, obviously getting the point in the World Cup, and everyone was really happy, and I got back to Southampton and all of a sudden I was like training with the reserves and like finding it hard to get into first team squads and stuff, and I remember sat in my house one day thinking I shouldn't really come away from a World Cup and then not being able to play for my parent club. It was strange, and then having to go out on loan from a League One team to a struggling League Two side was a bit tough to handle, but I mean I enjoyed where I went and I did get to play football and get more experience, but yeah, it was very strange. I couldn't quite understand how something like that would happen.
Now that you, when you look back at that experience, do you think it's made you more of a man as a player, maturity has grown?
Yeah, it's definitely taught me to grab opportunities, and to, no matter where you're playing or who you're playing for, you've got the same attitude and got to carry yourself in the same way and never kind of let anything go to your head. Like, obviously coming back from playing in a World Cup to thinking, obviously a lot of people would have thought, oh, a big player now, a big name, and obviously straight after the Under 20 World Cup, I got the senior team call up as well, so a lot of that could have gone to my head, but I kind of kept my feet grounded, and it taught me to be a lot more humble than anything else.
You know, tell us, for us back in Trinidad, you know, what's it like for a player like yourself when you go back to maybe a club like Southampton or your present club? Does the fact that you play international football and you're with a national team in Trinidad and Tobago, obviously we've gone downhill to some extent since 2006, but is there still some level of respect for an international like yourself playing for Trinidad and Tobago when you go back to your club? Is this among the fans or the teammates, is there still some form of, okay, he's an international player?
I think you got to look at it as, I think every footballer you'd speak to or whatever, I think the height is international football. Everyone wants to play in a World Cup. I mean, that's the be all and end all, like, that's what everyone wants to do. And if you play for a national team, like, it could be for England or Trinidad or San Marino, it's, you hear international player and you do think, oh, okay, it does earn a lot more respect than, like, I mean, I could be the same level, the same ability as someone else who's English, and if you got it down on a piece of paper and a manager or someone looks at it and says, oh, you have so-and-so, done this, and then me, it's got international footballer written next to it, I mean, people are going to think, oh, what, like, it's always a plus, and I think the fans always see, oh yeah, international player, we got an international player for the club, and before I came, all the other players were saying, oh, like, you're so lucky, I'd love to play international football and stuff. It's really nice to hear.
Great to hear, Jake. At your current club now, what's it like, you know, you've had to make the switch over and obviously adjust into a new environment and get yourself in there again to, you know, maybe aspire to greater things or to get a spot back in international football, and you've done that. So what's that been like for you?
It was tough because I joined Exeter and I had a season there, and I just felt myself it was too far away from home and I wasn't really happy playing there. And I went away for the summer, like took my focus off football, just went and had fun. And then over like the start of the season, I've tried to get myself back into it, and obviously went where I was at Kettering, just trying to get back into playing games and training and getting your name thrown out there again. It's tough, but it's also quite exciting because you kind of get to remember actually you're quite a good player, and it's more enjoyable than probably what it was before. But yes, it's a lot more exciting.
You mentioned earlier outside of the camera that, you know, the league itself is pretty attractive because you're finding that it's even more competitive than League One or League Two football, because a lot of the players they are now branching off into this particular league.
Yeah, the Premiership gets obviously the most coverage, and then the Championship gets a lot, but League One and League Two doesn't really get a lot of coverage, and it's not like you have to stay up until like 1 o'clock in the morning to see any kind of highlights. But the Conference, like, there's more live games being shown, and I think there's teams that'll pay more wages, and there are more fans go and watch it sometimes in a few cases, and yeah, it's a lot more attractive and stuff. But I think the aim is still, like, you want to say you're a league footballer and you play for a league club. So in some respects the Conference is like a lot of good players are stepping down in the league base, but in ability and quality wise it's no step down. But a lot of players are making that change, and I think maybe in 2-3 years' time the Conference will be a really, really competitive.
What's your status like at Kettering right now? Are you on contract or are you still trying to secure something?
Well, no. What it is I've kind of only signed for a month to get some fitness and play some games, because I hadn't done a real pre-season anywhere, and that month's ended now, and I've had a few offers from league clubs, and I'm going to go and train with a League One club when I get home, which should be good. I mean, I went on loan there before as Bournemouth, so hopefully when I get back that will all be sorted and I have the chance to go and train with them.
Okay, sounds good. Looking now ahead to tomorrow's encounter against Barbados, you've never played against an island like this, and maybe it's your first experience for World Cup action in the Caribbean. What are your expectations and what are your hopes for the team itself?
I think us as a country now, we've got to start becoming a little bit more arrogant and saying we are the best country in the Caribbean, and we've got to come to places like Barbados and teams like Bermuda and stamp our authority and start winning comfortably. And we went to look at the stadium and the pitch and stuff this afternoon, and it's not what you'd hope for. So I think in that respect the game would be really tough, because we're not used to it, and obviously the Barbados team will know what it's about. But I, in my personal self, I expect to win the game and put in a better performance than what we did against Bermuda. And of course that will come because we managed to play a full 90 minutes and train some more, so the team become more gelled, and I think we can only get a lot better than what we've done. But like, what we can't do anything else but win games, and it doesn't matter whether you play blind football and pass teams off the park and win 5-6-0 or you win 1-0, it's still 3 points on the board. So I think we'd expect more of the same tomorrow.
You mentioned that you go back to England and you go to another club, maybe see what happens best ever. What are your ambitions now for 2 to 3 years? You're still pretty young. Where do you see yourself maybe by 2014?
Well, by 2014 I should hope I'm preparing to pack for Brazil. But I'd hope to kind of be settled in a league club, get a full season under my belt, because I've never really played a full 30, 35, 40 game season yet. So I want to do that, score some goals and establish myself in a Trinidad and Tobago show.
Excellent, we wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Great one.